So today I will move into a device. We will, like as I told, we'll go through two parallel ways. One is those fundamental sensors and amplifiers, those that will be one track, and another track will be some devices. Okay. So today we'll do stethoscope. Not working. Oh, less so is also. We'll do stethoscope. So you can, there is a lot of dictation in this. So I dictate and you write. Okay. Stethoscope is an acoustic medical device. Stethoscope is an acoustic medical device. Okay. For auscultation. Stethoscope is an acoustic medical device for auscultation or listening to internal sounds of an animal or human body, or listening to internal sounds, or listening to internal sounds of an animal or human body. Animal or human body. Okay, it typically has a small disc-shaped resonator. It typically has a small disc-shaped resonator that is placed against the chest. And two tubes connected to earpieces. It typically has a small disc-shaped resonator that is placed against the chest and two tubes connected to earpieces. Okay. It is often used to listen to lung and heart sounds. It is often used to listen to lung and heart sounds. It is also used to listen to intestines and blood flow in arteries. Sound bhi sunne ko it is used. Okay. So in the stethoscope you have these two sides. If you look at that the chest piece. On the chest piece you typically have two sides, one on the back side and on the front side. So, and there is a link here. You can rotate this piece about this link. Click okay. It rotates. Okay, so if you rotate it to one side, then you will be able to use this side as your as your chest piece. If you click it to the other side, you'll be using this side as your chest piece. Okay? So this side is used for listening to low frequency sounds. Okay. For example, breathing, or for intestine sounds. This side is for higher frequency sounds, like to look at or to listen to heart sounds. In combination with sphygmomanometer, it is commonly used for measurement of blood pressure. In combination with sphygmomanometer is commonly used for measurement of blood pressure. So everybody knows how to measure blood pressure using stethoscope. Those who have taken last human physiology, they have done. Those who haven't, they can try doing it in the lab if the time permits. Okay. Then a little bit of history about this device, because it is the symbol of a doctor. So doctor ko kaam ho na, wo laga ke ghumta rehta. So that is a recognition ki haan ye doctor, right? So that's why stethoscope is the symbol of being a doctor. So that's why it has a long history of use. So the stethoscope was invented in France by René Laennec. Something of that sort his name was. So why he invented is because he was uncomfortable placing his ears onto woman's chest. Okay, so pehle kaan laga ke sunte the. So he was uncomfortable doing it. So he observed that a rolled piece of paper placed between patient's chest and his ear, could amplify heart sounds. Yeah. Without requiring physical contact. And the initial device which he had looked something just like this. So stetho means chest, and scope means something which you used to look at. Okay, stethoscope. Then it's new, another modification which came. It looks something of this sort. This is another early stethoscope. Okay. In 1851, Irish physician Arthur Leard, invented a binaural stethoscope. Okay, इसमें एक ही कान यूज होता था, only one ear. So Arthur Leard in 1851 developed this binaural stethoscope. This has become the standard ever since, where you have these two ear pieces. Okay. In 1873, there are descriptions of differential stethoscope. Differential stethoscope matlab, there is another type of, ye to standard stethoscope hamara ho gaya tha. I will not, so there is a single tube, which then goes to a earpiece. Sorry, chest piece. So this is your chest piece. These are your earpieces. And this is the tube. So in 1873, there were descriptions of differential stethoscope that could connect to slightly different locations. So differential stethoscope would have two chest pieces. Two different chest pieces. Ek idhar lagaya, ek idhar lagaya. Something of this sort. So they could hear sounds from two different positions simultaneously. To create a slightly stereo effect, though this did not become a standard tool in clinical practice. Okay, differential stethoscope clinical tool. Then there is another stethoscope, which I think we have one of these in our lab, which is Rapport and Sprague. Rapport and Sprague designed a new stethoscope in 1990 that became a standard by which other stethoscopes are measured. Rapport Sprague wala dekhte hain, if I can find. So this is the, we have one of these in our, actually this one. Yeah, this is the diagram, you can see that. Then how do stethoscopes actually amplify sound from the chest? If you directly put your ear versus you put a chest stethoscope, you can actually hear there is amplification of sound. Okay. So it is pretty amazing that a mechanical system without any electronic amplification is producing a amplified sound. Okay. So the concept behind this amplification is that of standing waves. So standing waves, standing wave phenomena. Is responsible for amplification. Is responsible for amplification of sound in a stethoscope. Okay. So how do standing waves work? Stethoscope is a, so there are two types of tube which you study in, those who come from, have done physics. Physics mein shayad hoga ye aapka padha hoga apne, open close, one side open, one side closed tube versus both side open tube. If tube is both side open, suppose you take a, suppose this one is, if you take this tube, so this is one side close and it is one side open. So if you blow air onto this, that is, if you vibrate the air column on the top of this, you will start hearing a sound. But that sound has a frequency. You can calculate that frequency based on the length of this tube. It's not, I am not able to blow it. If somebody else has, they can try. I had last year, I had shown one there is a frequency analyzer. This one. So if somebody can blow their whistle, we can see the frequency. Or let me. Yeah, blow it. Yeah, blow it, blow it. So this peak here, it came here, okay, around this point. फिर से करो इसी point पे आएगा. So that peak will be shown here. ये point देख रहे हैं? यहाँ पर वो peak का value दिखाएगा. Around 1500, around 1500 hertz or something. ठीक है? This one is a smaller tube, so it will have a higher frequency. Around 7000. So we'll see how to calculate this. So suppose this one, was what? This one was a open tube from one side. Pencil ka jo cap hai, ya pen ka cap hai, that is open from one side, closed from the other side. Okay? So that means the air molecules at this point can vibrate as much as possible. Maximum jitna ho sakta hai, they can vibrate. But air molecules at this point cannot change their position because there is no way to go to the other side. Okay? So that means if I plot the displacement of the air molecule, on this tube, what are the waveforms that can be supported on this? So one wave which can be supported on this is maximum here, maximum of the frequency of the waveform here, and minimum of the frequency here, minimum of the waveform here. तो ये वेवफॉर्म फाइनली कैसा दिखेगा? इट विल बी कंप्लीट एक फुल वेवफॉर्म इसका. दिस इज वन फुल वेवफॉर्म, राइट? और दिस इज हाफ वेवफॉर्म. दिस इज हाफ, ओके? सो दिस इज हाफ, सो दैट मींस दिस इज क्वार्टर वेवलेंथ. दिस इज लैम्डा बाई 4, क्योंकि पूरा वेवलेंथ क्या होगा? पूरा वेवलेंथ होगा यहां तक रिटर्न, यहां से निकला यहां पर रिटर्न. सो दैट मींस this is quarter of the wavelength, the fundamental frequency which can be supported on this. Isse lower frequency we cannot support, we can only support minimum this frequency, right? So iske liye wavelength hai lambda by 4, and this length of this tube is l, say, okay? Then l equal to lambda by 4, so that means lambda equal to 4l. So frequency equal to, frequency kya hota hai? Velocity by wavelength, velocity by lambda. Velocity in air is 340 meters per second divided by lambda is 4l. ठीक है? तो तुम्हारे उसका कितना length है? That one, if you calculate the length of it approximately, 5. So say we put 340 divided by 4 into 5 into 10 to power minus 2 centimeter. तो ये आएगा कितना? 340 by 20 into, so around 1500. सो वही देख रहे थे हम उधर, राइट? सो यू कैन कैलकुलेट दैट व्हाट इज द फंडामेंटल फ्रीक्वेंसी, एंड इट विल, जब आप इसको ब्लो करेंगे इसके पास, यू विल सी देयर विल बी फंडामेंटल फ्रीक्वेंसी, एंड देयर विल बी अदर फ्रीक्वेंसी उसके बाद कैसे आएंगे. ठीक है? व्हाट आर दीज फ्रीक्वेंसीज? ओके, दैट ऑल्सो यू कैन कैलकुलेट. द नेक्स्ट वन, द नेक्स्ट वेव फॉर्म विच कैन बी सपोर्टेड ऑन ए ओपन ट्यूब, ओपन ऑन वन साइड, इज, ये साइड हमेशा टॉप पे रहेगा, मतलब इट विल, नेक्स्ट वन विल बी हियर एंड हियर. ओके, सो दिस इज व्हाट, दिस इज, दिस पॉइंट टू दिस पॉइंट इज लैम्डा बाई 2, दिस पॉइंट टू दिस पॉइंट इज लैम्डा बाई 4. So total is 3 lambda by 4. ठीक है?
3 lambda by 4.
Okay. So 3 lambda by 4 equal to L, the next frequency which can be supported in this tube. So that means 3 lambda by 4 equal to L. That implies lambda equal to 4L by 3. So ab isme, so frequency equal to frequency second harmonic. This one was the fundamental. First harm, this is the fundamental, we call it F0. Okay? This is the first harmonic, F1. F1 is what? 340, which is V, divided by 4L by 3. That is equal to 3V by 4L. Right? So this is the next. So uske baad wala kya aayega? F2. F2 nikalenge. So first one was V by lambda, F0. Sorry, V by 4L. Isko likh deta hu, V by 4L. That is equal to 3 by 4L. Second one is 3V by 4L. Third one will be 5V by 4L. Iske baad wala calculate karenge. 5V by 4L. Theek hai? So Fn, nth harmonic, is given by n plus 2n plus 1. 2n plus 1 V by 4L. Theek hai? Nth harmonic of the frequency is given by 2n plus 1 V by 4L. So any tube if you take, if you blow onto it, you will see these frequencies. Just a harmonium, if you take and play the key, harmonium may a monotone, have you played a monotone? Monotone hota hai jisme single frequency hoti hai. That is very irritating. हमने पिछली बार क्या हुआ ना ऐसे आओ बस एक ही टोन है उसमें सिंगल साइनोसॉइड इफ यू प्ले सिंगल साइनोसॉइड यू विल जनरली फील इट वेरी इरिटेटिंग ओके बट हारमोनियम विल प्ले द सेम फ्रीक्वेंसी जैसे जनरली आपके सा का फ्रीक्वेंसी होता है अराउंड 110 हर्ज अगर आप सिर्फ 110 हर्ज का साइनोसॉइड प्ले करेंगे इट विल नॉट साउंड दैट गुड But once you play on harmonium that same sa, you will feel as if it is better. Why it is? Because you are hearing the same, you are hearing the first frequency which is 110, second one which is 220 or something of that sort, you know. Is formula ke hisab se, jo bhi aayega, you know. So that's why it is a combination of multiple frequencies. So even when you are speaking, our tone, we cannot typically generate single frequencies because of the structure of the voice box. When you create any sound, there will be multiple harmonics which will be supported on that, right? And many times the same song in the same scale, two people are singing, but one person sounds better. This is called the quality of the voice. Wo kahan se aati hai? Because of the structure of the voice box, ya fir माउथ का जो स्ट्रक्चर है उसकी वजह से वही सेम एग्जैक्ट टोन वही गा रही है और समथिंग समबडी एल्स इज सिंगिंग और यू विल हियर एज इफ देयर इज अ डिफरेंस इन क्वालिटी ऑल्दो फ्रॉम इन द फ्रीक्वेंसी चार्ट दे माइट लुक ऑलमोस्ट सिमिलर बट देयर विल बी लिटिल बिट डिफरेंस इन टर्म्स ऑफ दिस फ्रीक्वेंसी वर्सेस दिस फ्रीक्वेंसी वर्सेस दिस फ्रीक्वेंसी का जो एम्पलीट्यूड है एंड दैट गिव्स द डिफरेंट क्वालिटी ऑफ द साउंड कौन सा नेचुरल गिफ्ट Anybody can sing, but the natural gift वहाँ पे आता है because everybody can generally generate tones because tone कहाँ से generate हो रहा है? Tone is generating from the voice box and voice box or larynx. Like larynx का जो vibration frequency होता है, वो कोई भी generate कर सकता है. Everybody can generate any almost in the human range of frequency है. Everybody can generate that. With practice, anybody can reach up to three octaves hai ki sare gama pa dha ni sa, phir next sare gama pa dha ni sa, next sare gama. Two octaves tak to koi bhi kar lega, ek saal practice kare to, theek hai? But uske baad jo uske, yahaan se leke yahaan tak ka jo delivery ka jo structure hai, usme thoda jo variation hai, that gives the quality of the sound. So that's why the same song somebody else might be singing, exactly pitch perfect, but still you will feel as if there is a some one person's song appears little better because of the mouth and the nostril structure. And so that's why I'm saying that anybody can sing, But there is also a natural gift which comes from the structure of the mouth and the nostril. Next is, but in the stethoscope case, you have an open tube. Open tube means ek side mein aapka jo chest mein the chest piece is connected to the chest, okay? And then you have a tube, and then this side is connected to your ear. Okay, so this side is also vibrating with chest. Jaise the way the chest is moving, the chest jaise move kar raha, this diaphragm is moving with the chest. So that means it is equivalent to an open tube. Open tube mein kya hota hai, air ka movement uske surface mein jaisa hai, yahan par air ka movement jo bhi hai, is surface mein jo air molecules hai, their movement corresponds to the movement of the air column there. So that's why I'm saying that although stethoscope appears as if it is closed on one side, but the structure is that of an open tube, because the diaphragm basically connects to the chest, and chest ka vibration jaise hota wo usko follow karta hai, isliye there is maximum movement on the surface. Sabse zyada movement kahan par hai stethoscope ke, uske surface chest piece par na. Chest piece is not static. If chest piece to be static, then you will say it is closed tube, but it is not closed, because that's why you say this is an open tube on one side, and the other side it is open to the ear. Okay, so this is an open tube. Okay, so if it is an open tube, what are the frequencies which can be supported on an open tube? Isko simple diagram kar deta hu. This is an open tube. So that means this side will support maximum variation, because you open to air. This side will also support maximum variation. So minimum frequency kya support kar sakte hain isko? Minimum will be something of this sort. Theek hai, isse kam aap nahi kar sakte, isse kam to straight line ho jayega. Okay, so any frequency, any time varying signal, minimum which you can support on this is this. So this is what, this is a half wavelength. This is a half wavelength, right? Yeah, so this is lambda by 2, and it is supported on a tube length which is L. So your lambda by 2 equal to L, that means lambda equal to 2L. Lambda by 4? Ye hai minus 1 se 1. Ek sinusoid aap dekhiye jo, to yahan se leke yahan tak kya hai ye? Lambda by 2, because yahan se leke yahan tak lambda hai na. यहां से लेके यहां तक तो लैम्डा बाय 2 हो. सो नेक्स्ट वाला निकाले, नेक्स्ट मोड क्या है? नेक्स्ट मोड क्या है? नेक्स्ट मोड कैसे करेंगे? फर्स्ट वन विल स्टार्ट हियर, गो लाइक दिस, ठीक है? सो this is again L, this point to this point, it is what? Lambda. So lambda equal to L. Yahan pe frequency kya tha? Frequency was V by 2L. Here frequency is, sorry, V by L. This is F0, this is F1, F2. Plus 1 by 4, 1 plus ये लैम्डा बाय टू है ना, ये लैम्डा बाय टू है. सो लैम्डा प्लस लैम्डा बाय टू, थ्री लैम्डा बाय टू. सो थ्री लैम्डा बाय टू इज इक्वल टू एल, लैम्डा इक्वल टू टू एल बाई थ्री. सो एफ थ्री एफ टू इक्वल टू थ्री वी बाई टू एल. ठीक है, तो फॉर्मूला आ जाएगा आपका एफ एन इक्वल टू, फॉर्मूला बताइए. हाँ, एफ एन इक्वल टू एन प्लस वन वी बाई टू एल, राइट. ये सेकेंड के लिए वही हो जाएगा टू टू प्लस सॉरी वन प्लस वन वी बाई टू एल, वी बाई एल. ठीक है, सो दिस इज योर, दिस इज द फॉर्मूला फॉर स्टेथोस्कोप. स्टेथोस्कोप का फ्रीक्वेंसी कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऐसा आएगा. सो फाइनली इफ यू प्लॉट द फ्रीक्वेंसी कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ ए स्टेथोस्कोप, इट माइट लुक समथिंग ऑफ दिस सॉर्ट. इज इन लॉग स्केल, gain but in log scale, and this side it is frequency. ठीक है, सो इसमें पहला फ्रीक्वेंसी जो फंडामेंटल फ्रीक्वेंसी क्या है, इसमें फंडामेंटल फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ द ट्यूब एफ नॉट 100 हर्ट्ज. तो फंडामेंटल फ्रीक्वेंसी जैसे ही पता चलेगा, यू कैन फाइंड आउट द नेक्स्ट हार्मोनिक्स बिकॉज इट इज ओपन ओपन ट्यूब. ये फंडामेंटल फ्रीक्वेंसी विच इज वी बाई टू एल, राइट, विच इज वी बाई टू एल इज इक्वल टू 100 हर्ट्ज. देन ये है आपका F0, तो F1 क्या हुआ, F1 क्या हुआ, F0 है ये, F0 मतलब n इक्वल टू जीरो डाला, सो वी गेट 100 हर्ट्ज. तो n इक्वल टू वन डालने पर 200 हर्ट्ज, n इक्वल टू 300 हर्ट्ज, 400 हर्ट्ज. ओके, सो एवरी, सो ये फर्स्ट वन विल कम एट 100, सेकंड इज कमिंग 200, थर्ड 300, 400, 500. ठीक है, यू कैन ऑल्सो यूज इट इन रिवर्स. सो इससे आप लेंथ ऑफ ट्यूब डिटरमाइन कर सकते हैं कि नहीं, एक स्टेथोस्कोप का लेंथ कैन यू डिटरमाइन बाय लुकिंग एट दिस ग्राफ. इफ यू नो द साउंड स्पीड, यू कैन बैक कैलकुलेट द स्पीड द स्टेथोस्कोप्स लेंथ. सो इससे व्हाट डज दिस ग्राफ टेल अस अबाउट स्टेथोस्कोप, इट डजंट हैव अ फ्लैट बैंड. फ्लैट बैंड मीन्स इट डजंट एम्पलीफाई ऑल साउंड्स इक्वली, देर आर सर्टन फ्रीक्वेंसीज विच एम्पलीफाइज मोर, सर्टन विच एम्पलीफाइज लेस. So ideally for a good transmission line, we typically want the transmission line to have a flat band, wo frequency ko distort na kare. But because doctors have been trained over hundreds of years now on this, unke training bhi isi pe karte hain, so that's why they are more accustomed to this rather than if you give them electronic stethoscope which is frequency adjusted, all bands flat, means the final frequency curve for your electronic stethoscope might be a flat band, all frequencies get passed equally. But still there has not been much acceptance in clinical community for such stethoscopes, although electronic stethoscopes are there in market, but they are still not typically not very accepted by doctors. They still prefer this one. So many types of electronic stethoscopes have been proposed. These have selectable frequency characteristics ranging from ideal flat response case and selected band passes to typical mechanical stethoscope, means even band pass filter electronically designed this kind of band characteristics. Physicians, however, have not generally accepted these electronic stethoscopes, mainly because they are unfamiliar with the sounds heard from them. Okay. So this completes the stethoscope. So tomorrow, in next week, I am not here. So tomorrow is the last class before mid-sem. So I want to do a little bit electrosurgical devices, and that will be our last before mid-sem. I'll do it in more detail tomorrow. Today, let's just have some dictation. An ESU, this is also called as ESU. The ones which you saw in Karnak, they have, many of these laparoscopic devices have electrosurgical units attached, means you can attach electrosurgical units to them. Electrosurgical unit is basically using electrical power to do surgery. You can use electrical current to cut tissue. You can also use it to join. You can also use it to dry up a particular, for example, blood nikal raha, you want to clot it. So there are different modes through which you can achieve that. Okay. So you can write, an ESU passes high frequency electric current. An ESU passes high frequency electric current through biological tissues. An ESU passes high frequency electric current through biological tissues to achieve surgical modification of the tissue, such as cutting, coagulation. Coagulation is clotting or process of blood changing from liquid to gel. Number 3, desiccate. Process of extreme dryness. Okay, this is something to do with, for example, you want to dry up a particular tissue. Okay, this is desiccation. Number 4 is fulguration or also called as ablation. Ablation is totally burning of the tissue. Okay. Electrosurgery is also known as high frequency surgery or surgical diathermy. Also known as high frequency surgery or surgical diathermy. Okay. And fundamental frequency of ESU is greater than 200 kilohertz. बाद में मोबाइल देख लेना भाई. इलेक्ट्रोसर्जरी इज ऑल्सो नोन एज, नहीं क्या था, फंडामेंटल फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ ईएसयू इज ग्रेटर देन 200 किलोहर्ट्ज़. टू मिनिमाइज पोटेंशियल फॉर न्यूरोमस्कुलर स्टिमुलेशन, फंडामेंटल फ्रीक्वेंसी ESU greater than 200 kilohertz to minimize potential for neuromuscular stimulation. What do you mean by neuromuscular stimulation? Like if you get if the current is of low frequency and it is passing through certain neuronal pathways where the neuron is carrying signals to the arm or carrying signals to the leg, if you have a lower frequency signal within which you have the absolute refractory period not passed, absolute refractory period is suppose 1 millisecond. So that means any frequency above 1 kilohertz, below 1 kilohertz, can excite those muscles again and again. So there can be vibration in the patient. So that's why you what you do is you pass a high frequency. So even if there is some stimulation occurring, it will not lead to these vibratory motions in the body. Okay. Then cutting is achieved with continuous sinusoidal waveform. Cutting is achieved with continuous sinusoidal waveform while coagulation is achieved with a series of sinusoidal wave packets. Cutting is achieved with a continuous sinusoidal waveform while coagulation is achieved with a series of sinusoidal wave packets. Surgeon selects either one or a blend of them. To suit the surgical needs. There are two methods. There are two primary application methods. One is monopolar and second one is bipolar. Okay. In the monopolar mode, intent is slow here. Here I can show you. Okay. So in the monopolar mode, the current flows from a small active electrode onto the surgical site. Spreads through the body. In the monopolar mode, the current flows from a small active electrode onto the surgical site. It spreads through the body and returns to a large dispersive electrode. The current flows from a small active electrode onto the surgical site. spreads through the body and returns to a large dispersive electrode on the skin. No, it's like, for example, here you can see, okay, it's like, for example, if this is the body and you are applying a current here, it's a very pinpointed, so here you are applying a high voltage, not a DC, AC, okay, a high voltage DC, and then you have a return electrode which is applied on the body. ठीक है, body में हो सकता पूरे thigh में एक लगाया है, thigh में लगाते हैं typically, यहाँ पर thigh में एक बड़ा electrode लगा हुआ है, and this is coming back here. So then what happens is all the electrons which are entering into the body, they will enter from this point, and then they will return through this, right? तो maximum energy कहाँ पे produce होगा? जिस पॉइंट पर है ना, वहीं पे जहां पे एंटर कर रहा है, बिकॉज देयर इज मैक्सिमम अमाउंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स फ्लोइंग थ्रू ए स्मॉल एरिया. सो व्हाट वाज द फॉर्मूला फॉर आवर रेजिस्टेंस? रेजिस्टेंस में जो रो एल बाई ए, रेजिस्टिविटी का फॉर्मूला, रेजिस्टेंस का फॉर्मूला था क्या? रो एल बाई ए. सो इफ एरिया गोज डाउन, रेजिस्टेंस गोज, एक्चुअली दिस इज नॉट द राइट वे ऑफ लुकिंग एट इट, बिकॉज देयर इज नो रेजिस्टेंस इन दिस. दिस इज जस्ट how much electrons, if there are more number of electrons flowing through a particular point, there will be more heat generated. Okay, so the same amount of electron are also exiting the body, but they are exiting through a larger area. Okay, and so the amount of heat which is produced here is much higher than the amount of heat which is produced here. Okay, aur kai bar ye itna zyada high voltage hota hai because the pin jitna zyada pointed hoga, the more the pointed the pin is, the electrode, active electrode is, the more the current density at that point. Theek hai, so you can have a thicker electrode and you will have less current density. If you have a very pinpointed electrode, you will have very high current density with the same voltage. Theek hai, and it will be so high that I will show you in the diagrams, like when the electrode comes near the body, there will be sparks, right? And the sparks itself will start cutting, you don't have even have to touch it. Theek hai, so where was that? This one. So this is the monopolar mode. Then bipolar, bipolar mode. Yeah. No, because the current it dips. Concept. Right. But nearby surface means ab wo depend karta hai tumhara electrode ka thickness kitna hai. But it is not that ki bahut bada incision nahi create hoga. It will be very narrow, within millimeter, within sub millimeters me I, and that is fine. Within half a millimeter is also fine. And the current actually reduces as a power of, oh, formula ek hai, when we'll discuss, it reduces as a power of current density. So current density ka square power mein reduce hota hai. It reduces as a power, square power of current density. So current density jaise hi reduce hona shuru hoga, uske square power mein heat generate, jitna heat generate ho raha hai us area mein, this will start reducing at a square relationship. Theek hai, that formula when it comes I will show you. This is the this is electrocautery or the bipolar mode. Theek hai, in the bipolar mode current, pichle wala kya kahan tak kiya tha humne, large dispersive electrode, isme aur ek line likh lo, current density is high at the active electrode and low at the return electrode. Current density is active, high at the active electrode and low at the return electrode. Yeah, in the bipolar mode, or which is also called as electrocautery, current flows only through tissue in contact with bipolar electrodes in form of forceps. In bipolar mode, current flows only through tissue in contact. Current flows only through tissue in contact with bipolar electrodes in form of forceps. ठीक है, इसमें कोई return electrode दूसरे जगह body पे नहीं है, एक ही पॉइंट पर है, ठीक है, बट यू हैव टू टू इलेक्ट्रोड्स इन फॉर्म ऑफ फोर्स सेट. दोज आर सेपरेटेड बट दे हैव अ हाई पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस अक्रॉस देम. सो एज सून एज यू टच द बॉडी द करंट फ्लोज थ्रू दैट पोजिशन इन द बॉडी बैक टू द अदर इलेक्ट्रोड. सो हीट इज ओनली जनरेटेड लोकली बट मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम द अदर बाइपोलर इलेक्ट्रोड इज मोर कॉमन. ये मोनोपोलर वाला इज नॉट दैट कॉमन, ठीक है, because probably in monopolar you can create much more finer incisions than this. Okay. Okay. So tomorrow we'll continue rest. Thank you.